Welcome to Section 3 of Introduction to Image Processing. This section is about operations that affect contrast in an image. Here is a manipulate with sliders for controlling the brightness and the contrast of a sample image. Contrast is the range of colors in an image or the range between dark and light. This manipulate program uses a function called ImageAdjust, which will be described in more detail in a moment, but basically these controls work like the brightness and contrast controls that you might find on a television or on a computer monitor. The brightness control makes the image lighter or darker, which it does by making the pixel values bigger or smaller, and the contrast control works by changing the distribution of pixel values, either by moving pixel values closer to a single value, which lowers the contrast, or by spreading the pixel values out, which increases the contrast. A useful tool for describing brightness and contrast is a plot called an image histogram, which is a histogram of the pixel values in an image. Here is a histogram for this image. This is an RGB image, so there are actually three histograms, one for each of the three colors. The appearance separated option is included here so that the three histograms are drawn separately, rather than layering them on top of each other in one histogram. Here is another manipulate program to show both the image and the image histogram. Lowering the brightness makes all of the pixel values smaller, eventually becoming clustered near zero. And increasing the brightness makes the pixel values bigger, until much of the image is actually pure white. The contrast control has a different effect. Lowering the contrast moves all of the pixel values in towards some narrow part of the range. At minimum contrast, the range is so narrow that the image becomes a uniform gray, and increasing the contrast has the opposite effect, spreading pixel values out over the available range. One common special case of contrast adjustment is taking a low contrast image and linearly rescaling the pixel values by just the right amount so that the pixel values just fill the entire range of possible values. For example, here is an image with relatively low contrast. The low contrast shows up in the image histogram as pixel values concentrated in part of the range of possible values. The range of pixel values in that image can be stretched out using the ImageAdjust function, which gives an image where the pixel values fill the whole range of values from 0 to 1 instead of being concentrated in part of the range. What the ImageAdjust function does is fairly simple. The basic idea is to find the minimum and maximum pixel values in the image and then work out a linear function that returns 0 for the minimum value and 1 for the maximum value. Then stretch out the contrast by applying that function to every pixel in the image, which can be done in the Wolfram language using the ImageApply function. The result is an image with greater contrast because the range of pixel values has been stretched to fill the whole range of possible values. The transformation function that was used in that example is fairly typical of transformations for adjusting brightness and contrast. The plot of this function is a straight line. This particular function was set up so that the maximum pixel value transforms to 1, the minimum pixel value transforms to 0, and other pixel values transform according to this straight line, with the effect being that the range of pixel values in the input image is stretched in the output image to fill the full range from 0 to 1. This function was applied to an image where all of the pixel values fell in a certain narrow range. But the same sort of transformation can be applied even when the pixel values do not fall in such a range. For example, here is a function that gives a linear transformation for a certain range of pixel values and transforms values below that range to 0 and values above that range to 1. The effect of that transformation is to maximize contrast for pixels in the selected range and to turn everything else either black or white. Here is a manipulate for adjusting the interval to emphasize different aspects of the image. If the endpoints are adjusted so that the length of the interval is 0, then the transformation becomes a common operation called binarizing the image, where all of the pixels transform to either black or white. In the Wolfram language, binarizing an image can be done using the binarize function. The second argument in the binarize function is a number called the threshold, which is the level where the pixels switch from black to white. Here is a manipulate for adjusting the threshold. When the threshold is 0, everything transforms to white, and when the threshold is 1, everything transforms to black. Setting the threshold anywhere between 0 and 1 picks out different parts of the image. There are many piecewise linear transformations that can be useful in different situations. For example, here is another manipulate, this time with a color image, where pixels outside of a selected brightness range are left unchanged and pixels inside that range are replaced by a contrasting color. The image in this example is a satellite image in which adjusting the selected range has the effect of highlighting certain geographic features in the image. When the contrast of an image is stretched, it sometimes happens that an image that should look like the first image here turns out looking like the second image with distinct boundaries between different levels of shading. In practical examples, the effect is often not quite so dramatic, but still shows up in the image histogram as a histogram with pixel values only at a discrete set of intensity levels. The cause of this behavior in this example is the limited number of intensity levels in the image. This image is a byte image, which means that each pixel value is represented by a byte in the computer. Computer bytes have 8 binary bits, and so 256 possible values, which in a grayscale image like this one means 256 shades of gray. The number of bits used to represent each pixel in an image is called the bit depth of the image, so byte images are sometimes described as having a bit depth of 8. The image data function with second argument automatic shows the native form for the pixel values, which for a byte image is integers from 0 to 255. For convenience, the pixel values are typically divided by 255 so that the values range from 0 to 1, but there are still only 256 possible values. Using only one byte for each pixel value saves computer memory, and 256 shades of gray is actually more than enough for most images, but one situation where it is sometimes not enough is in images with very low contrast. Here is a demonstration that has been set up to illustrate the problem. This program includes some details that aren't of immediate interest here. This program is basically an image apply operation for lowering the contrast under the control of the first slider, and a second image apply for stretching the contrast under the control of the second slider. The display also includes a plot that is kind of like the image histogram shown earlier, except that this histogram gives the number of pixels at every available intensity level. Zooming in on that histogram for the original image shows that the pixels fall on evenly spaced values, and the vertical scale shows that there are hundreds of pixels at each value, so hundreds of pixels for each of the 256 possible shades of gray. If the contrast is reduced, the spacing between possible pixel values stays the same, since this is still a byte image, but the pixel values that are used in the image become concentrated in a small part of the range, so that this particular example uses only 14 different gray levels. If those 14 levels are then stretched out to fill the whole range, the result is the image shown earlier with visible boundaries between different shades of gray. This sort of contrast stretching is what the image adjust function does, and contrast stretching applied to a very low contrast byte image is one way to get an image with visible boundaries between the gray levels. This effect, where there are differences between the colors or brightness levels that are used in an image, is called quantization. Sometimes quantization is introduced intentionally to reduce the number of colors needed in an image or to achieve other special effects. You can specify the number of colors for an image, or for this grayscale image, the number of shades of gray, using the color quantize function. Here is an input that gives a result that uses 8 shades of gray. This input also includes the dithering option set to false. Dithering is a process for creating the illusion of additional shades of gray or additional colors by mixing together pixels with different colors or different shades of gray. To illustrate how that can work, here is an example that uses only 2 shades of gray, but with dithering now turned on. Dithering mixes the 2 shades of gray together in different ratios to give the appearance of additional shades of gray. This particular image has relatively low resolution, but in an image with a higher density of pixels, the dithering can be almost invisible. Another way of dealing with quantization effects is to start with an image that uses more than 256 intensity levels. For example, here is an image that is probably indistinguishable from the earlier image, at least on the computer screen, but this image uses far more than 256 intensity levels. This image has image type real, so each pixel is represented by a real number that gives many billions of possible intensity levels. If the pixel values in this image are compressed to get a very low contrast image, the contrast can still be stretched back out, which is done here using the image adjust function, to use the full range of values from 0 to 1 with no visible boundaries between different shades of gray. This works because there are so many available intensity levels that even The low contrast image uses a different pixel value and a different shade of gray for every pixel. An image of type real uses about 8 times as much memory as a byte image and has an effective bit depth of about 50, but the extra levels can be useful in some applications. So far, all of the transformations have been linear or piecewise linear, but the transformation function can actually be almost anything. Probably the most common nonlinear transformation is a power law transformation with a formula like this one, where the pixel value is raised to some power. In image processing, the power is conventionally represented by the symbol gamma, and the transformation is called a gamma transformation or a gamma correction. Here is a manipulate that shows this transformation function for various values of gamma. Gamma of 1 is an identity transformation, gamma greater than 1 gives a curve that bends down, and gamma less than 1 gives a curve that bends up. Here is a sample image and a manipulate that shows a plot of the gamma transformation function and the effect of that function on the sample image. Gamma greater than 1 tends to compress the histogram for dark parts of the image, which reduces contrast in dark parts of the image and increases contrast in brighter parts of the image. Gamma less than 1 does the opposite, increasing contrast in dark parts of the image and reducing contrast in brighter parts of the image. The gamma transformation also has an effect on overall brightness. Gamma greater than 1 darkens the image, and gamma less than 1 brightens the image. In image processing software, controls for gamma transformation are often accompanied by controls for adjusting brightness. In the Wolfram language, these gamma and contrast and brightness adjustments are part of what the image adjust function is designed to do. The image adjust function can be used in several different ways, one of which is the form where the second argument includes parameters C, B, and gamma for adjusting contrast, brightness, and the gamma exponent. When used in this form, the image adjust function applies the formula shown here, where B is the brightness parameter, C is the contrast parameter, and the exponent is gamma. Here is a manipulate for showing the effect of that transformation on an image. The parameter B primarily affects brightness by increasing pixel values. The parameter C affects contrast by concentrating pixel values in part of the histogram, and the gamma parameter does gamma transformations. These controls can be useful for achieving a variety of image effects, basically by adjusting the distribution of pixel values in the image histogram. There are also some technical reasons for doing gamma transformation followed by the inverse gamma transformation. Some displayed devices, for example, like old cathode ray tube monitors, are more sensitive at higher input levels and effectively apply a gamma of around 2 or 2.5. One way of dealing with that problem is to do something called gamma encoding, which means apply a transformation with gamma less than 1 to the image before it goes to the device so that the image ends up looking normal when it is displayed. Gamma encoding is also used to make better use of the available intensity levels in images like byte images, where there is a limited set of intensity levels for each pixel. Human eyes are more sensitive to contrast in darker parts of an image, for example, so it makes sense to apply a transformation with gamma less than 1 when the image is stored so that more levels are used for dark parts of the stored image, and then reverse that transformation when the image is displayed so that displayed intensities are correct. Usually this sort of gamma encoding and decoding is done automatically in low-level software on the computer, but it is occasionally useful to do this sort of correction in applications. That's the end of the examples for this section. This section introduced various contrast adjustments, image histograms, image types and intensity resolution, and some common vocabulary related to these transformations. The next section covers pointwise operations for more directly manipulating the image histogram.